Greetings everyone! In this video, I will show you one way to create the circular progress bar featured in this discussion. I will also show you how you can use a pie-looking animation instead of a progress bar. Finally, as a bonus, I will demonstrate how to use videos instead of color clips as backgrounds to the circular bars. Add a color clip on track V2. Extend it to match the duration of the V1 clip. Add a crop rectangle filter. Edit the vertical size value to set the thickness of the line. Enable a 2x2 grid. Grab the bar in the preview and drag down until it snaps to the intersection of the grid lines. Click on the transparent button to reveal the background. With the playhead positioned at frame 0 of the timeline, enable the position and size keyframes. Move the playhead 5 seconds forward. Add a new keyframe at that position. Move the playhead to the first keyframe. Change the value of the horizontal size parameter to 0. Add a 360 equirectangular to stereographic filter. The animation starts from the bottom of the circle. To make it start at the top, change the roll value to 180 degrees. Add a timer filter. Enable Use Font Size. Edit the text color. Choose a font and edit the font size. Set horizontal fit to center and vertical fit to middle. Depending on the font used, the text may not be exactly centered on the screen. If this happens to you, edit the vertical position value to fine-tune the vertical alignment. Edit the duration value to fit the length of your animation. In my case, 5 seconds. The next steps are optional. I will add a 1-second text clip in front of the color clip to fade in the text of the timer. You'll see what I mean in a few seconds. Go to Open Other and create a text clip. Write 00.00 and click Open. Create a temporary V3 track. Drag the text clip to track V3. Move the playhead forward 1 second. Split the clip, and delete the excess footage. Drag the V2 clip 1 second forward. Drag down the text clip to track V2. Delete track V3. Select the text clip. Replicate the same color, font, size, and position values used in the timer filter. Add a 1 second fade in video filter and make sure adjust opacity instead of fade with black is enabled. Adding this text clip made the timer text fade in on the screen before the animation of the progress bar begins. As in part 1, create a color clip on track V2 and add a crop rectangle filter. Enable a 2x2 grid. In the preview, grab the upper handle and drag it down until it snaps to the horizontal line in the middle of the grid. Create the same two keyframes we used in part 1. Then add the 360 equirectangular to stereographic filter and set the roll value to 180 degrees. Open the playlist panel and import the video clips you want to use as backgrounds. Make sure they are at least as long as the clip on track V1. Grab one of the clips and bring it to V2. And trim it if needed. Add a crop rectangle filter and apply the same settings and keyframes we used in part 1. Add the 360 equirectangular to stereographic filter and set the roll value to 180 degrees. If you want to try other clips without having to repeat all these steps, go to the playlist and double-click on a clip. This will load it in the source panel. Then select the V2 clip in the timeline, right-click and choose Replace. I hope all this was helpful to you. Thanks for watching.